Incredible.
When I woke up today, I felt incredibly refreshed. Feeling more blessed than ever with no head full of stress. I was comfortable but calm in my warm spot. Didn't even abuse the snooze button or my alarm clock. Sun shining through the burgundy drapes. My lady wasn't next to me, I guess she working today. I'm accustomed to looking her in the face at 7 a.m. One particular person you see day out and day in. Anyway, I felt like this day may never come again. I need breakfast, I heard my stomach rumbling. No stumbling, I jumped out of bed in my boxes. My mission's to the kitchen for that leftover pasta. But stopped in my tracks in the middle of the living room. Saw my girl curled up crying, looking pitiful. Surrounded by a room full of trash bags and moving boxes. I started thinking about the dirt that I've been doing. Must be busted. I try to ask her what's wrong. She wouldn't even look in my direction. No discussion. Was it some romance with one of them up tramps? Or last night did I go on one of my drunken rants? I said, fine, you wanna treat me like I'm not here? And act like you can't answer a question of if I care. The best thing to do in this situation is leave home. But quickly notice both my smartphone and my keys gone.
Yo, where the hell are my keys?
But still she ignored it. Oh, forget, I'm walking up to the corner Korean store. For a bag of chips and coconut juice. To clear my mind and give us time that both of us can use. The store's close to my crib, a few feet at least. But the store owners, they be peeping me repeatedly. I walked in, nobody greeted me. For once, they ain't treat me like I was scheming on thievery. I grabbed a bag of Sun Chips, proceeded to the counter. This jerk of a clerk looked at my items dumbfounded. They snatched it off the counter, yelling in some native fast talk. I said, I'm never coming back in here, that was the last straw. What an itchy day it's been thus far. Man, this can't be the type of day I woke up for. Hopped on the city transit, today's pretty frantic. It started sublime, then declined, don't understand it, man. The only place to find peace, the only better choice, to seek silence is the vinyl in the record store. Plus that Brother Ali record I'm checking for. The atmosphere felt different when I stepped in the door. The music was low and it's hard to hear. The record shop, yo, it was like a graveyard in there. I stepped outside, wondering how could this day have gone wrong. But then the Chevy passed by with my song on. The local radio station, they had my song on. That's when I knew something was horribly wrong, homes. Cause they don't play no local music if it's homegrown. A motherfucker gotta be dead and long gone. Shot up and murdered. Wait, what? I jetted back in the store, I'm searching for the Charlotte Observer. Feeling faint, nauseous, and nervous. No wonder why nobody even noticed me, paid attention or turned heads. I started panicking as I was thinking back again. Stiff as a mannequin, like, yo, this can't be happening. Picked up the paper and the caption read after my name in bold black lettering, local rapper slain.
Yo, what the